Stanford University.
We think of this class as a think tank where drones can really take part in improving the delivery experience. Students learn the analytical design side, where students are going in and using computational fluid dynamics software to simulate the performance and the aerodynamics of airfoils, of wings. And then we also have given the students autonomous quadcopter kits. They're constructing the thing from raw components. They're setting up this quadcopter to be able to fly GPS waypoints completely autonomously. And then they move into this phase of prototyping the delivery mechanism, actually built them on campus and added actuators and servos to do all the movement.
It all started by coming up with a mission, and our team, you know, through some ideation and some D-school tactics, have come up with a mission to deliver keys to people who get locked out. Then from there, we went on to design a drone configuration that would be best suited for our payload. We wanted a lot of battery time for hover, and we wanted to be able to fly anywhere as quick as possible. We came up with a delivery mechanism that we thought was the best suited for this job, so we attached a little magnet to the end of a string, and we have a winch and motor system that, you know, brings the key and payload down and up when we want it to.
Our mission that we selected was to deliver a cupcake to somebody on their birthday. The biggest thing on this guy was adding the delivery mechanism. We laser cut pieces of acrylic, glued and screwed them together, and attached servo motors that kind of pushed this elastic mechanism open, which would release the cupcake box.
We teach quite a wide range of skills in this class, so aeronautics and fluids, to design and manufacturing, to a lot of programming and coding to be able to develop algorithms that can simulate performance. So even if our students come out of this class and don't end up designing drones as a career, you can still apply a lot of these techniques outside of the class.
For more, please visit us at stanford.edu.